What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NYFina, the most phenomenal voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go and subscribe to the phenomenal crew. Now, let's get to it. Listen, Jalen Hurts. It's Hurts season in Philly. Shout out to Jalen Hurts. Real talk, man. Shout out to Jalen Hurts, man. Listen, man. Listen. Carson Wentz has to go. Yo, we can pretty much confirm that Carson Wentz, he'll be playing in Indiana next year. Carson Wentz might be playing in Chicago. Carson Wentz might be playing even in San Francisco. But we can guarantee he won't be lacing up in Philly next year. He won't be lacing up in Philly in 2021. We can guarantee that. At the end of the day, shout out to Jalen Hurts, man. You can't name a better start off for a debut. A better start at the core position. Listen. Shout out to Jalen Hurts, man. Nobody picked Philly to win this game. Nobody. I know Eagles fans that didn't even have confidence going into this game. The Eagles season has been a dump this year. The Eagles just been pathetic all year long. They benched Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz ain't been shit all year long. This guy Carson Wentz has been a BUM bum. Dougie P has been a BUM bum. His offense overall has been a bunch of mess, a bunch of shit. And Jalen Hurts found a way to get it done, man. Like, what can you hate on? What can you hate? Listen, this guy Jalen Hurts did everything that Carson Wentz wouldn't have done. Carson Wentz wouldn't have extended those drives like Jalen Hurts did. You see in those read options how explosive Jalen Hurts did look off the edge. This guy Jalen Hurts, he got to that second level. He got to that second level, man. The Saints couldn't stop that read option. Shout out to Miles Sanders. Miles Sanders. He got over 100 yards. Let's just put this in perspective real quick. This Saints defense, this Saints defense hasn't gave up a 100-yard rusher, hasn't gave up a 100-yard rusher in, what was it, over 50 games? And the Eagles were able to get 200-yard rushes in the same game versus the same lights-out run defense? Listen, that comes down to Jalen Hurts. Say what you want to say. Say what you that the Eagles team is playing with confidence, and the Eagles started playing hard, and they just wanted to, you know, they weren't playing hard for Wentz, and they wanted to play hard for Hurts. Say what you want to say. But this Eagles team was able to get 200-yard rushes. They were able to get 200-yard rushes. That wouldn't happen with Wentz. Wentz wouldn't have been able to do that. Not only can't Wentz just, you know, get yards on the ground like Hurts can, he can't make the offense as dynamic as Hurts did. Hurts is running that Lamar Jackson zone read, Colin Kaepernick read option offense. He was running that same offense, and it worked. So at the end of the day, Eagles need to ride with Jalen Hurts for the rest of the year. Is y'all playoff chances out the window? Maybe so, but my thing is, listen, y'all got the Cardinals coming up, then y'all play the Cowboys in week 17, and y'all got another winnable game after that. I think y'all play the Bengals or something. So it's like at the end of the day, man, shout out to Jalen Hurts, man. You can't ask for a better debut to start off your career than what Jalen Hurts has did. Listen, people are talking about the Saints defense is the best defense in the league, and Hurts shit on them. Did he have the best passing game? No, not really. But he threw that dot to Alshon Jeffrey in the end zone. Shout out to Alshon Jeffrey. I haven't talked about Alshon Jeffrey in like since 2018. The last time I spoke about Alshon Jeffrey was 2018. This guy Alshon Jeffrey shows a pulse and catches a touchdown on Lattimore in the end zone. Shout out to the Eagles, man. Fly, Eagles, fly. Hey, at the end of the day, DK told y'all this 3 weeks ago to start Jalen Hurts. My man DK Metcalf and DJ Dallas told y'all to start DK 3 weeks ago. DK told y'all do this 3 weeks ago, and y'all, Eagles fans were all in their feelings. Eagles fans were all in their feelings about how could DK say that? How could he? 3 weeks later, y'all praising Jalen Hurts, y'all slurping Jalen Hurts because he led y'all to victory. That was all Jalen Hurts right there. This probably saved Dougie Peterson's job. This probably saved Doug Peterson's job, truth be told. Like, if Jalen Hurts shows that he's the truth for the rest of these last three games, and the Eagles, not even if they don't make the playoffs, let's say they finish 6-8-1. Let's say the Eagles finish, 6-9-1. That still saves Doug Peterson's job, because what Doug Peterson can say is, now since I got a quarterback that I can work with, now that the offense is more dynamic and you get that for the rest of the season, maybe we can make some moves in 2021. Maybe he can go to the owner like that. Maybe that can work. So, you know, at the end of the day, man, listen, we all knew that this day would probably come when Jalen Hurts got selected in the second round last year. This guy looked like a stud, man. Like I said, it's his passing. Like I said, he doesn't seem like the most natural passer, but he has enough in the toolbox to get it done, and that works. I mean, that dynamic on the ground, and it makes the offense more dynamic. Now Miles Sanders is looking like a top five back. Now when you got Miles Sanders looking like Saquon Barkley, then, you know, the offense just becomes more dynamic. I'm seeing Jalen Reagor get involved. I'm seeing Dallas Goedert get involved. I mean, it just looked like the perfect unit. All right, so, you know, at the end of the day, shout out to the Eagles, man. Listen, I made fun of y'all 3 weeks ago. Darius Slay's doing shit. But, you know, overall, like, y'all got it done versus the Saints. Y'all were the, what were y'all? Were y'all the 8-point underdogs going to this game? Yeah, y'all were the 7.5 underdogs going to this game. And y'all got it done, man. So, you know, overall, I'm not going to guarantee no playoffs for the Eagles or nothing. But at the end of the day, shout out to Jalen Hurts, man. I really did like what I saw from Jalen Hurts, man. Maybe if y'all started Jalen Hurts from Carson Wentz over Carson Wentz when DK told y'all to do that, maybe y'all be at 5 wins now. But at the end of the day, salute to Jalen Hurts. As far as the Saints and Taysom Hill is a bomb. I told y'all this. Taysom Tebow. Let me change myself. Let me excuse myself. I won't call him Taysom Hill in a phenomenal group. We call him Taysom Tebow because he's some shit. He is some absolute shit. There's no other way to say it. I just gotta take some tea. But the fact that Sean Payton has the audacity to start Taysom Tebow over a pure 5,000 yard quarterback in Jameis Winston, he deserves to be fired on spot. Like, listen, if I was a Saints fan, if I was part of the Who That Nation, I'll be calling for Sean Payton's job right now. I will be rioting in front of the Superdome right now. I'll be rioting in front of the Dome of Death right now for Sean Payton to get fired. There's no excuse. There's no reason to start this guy. This quote-unquote quarterback, this running back, this call him an athlete. He's nothing like a quarterback. He's an athlete. Taysom Tebow. There's no reason to start as Taysom Tebow over a 5,000-yard quarterback in Jameis Winston. The fact that you guys lost your number one seed, y'all deserve to lose that. Y'all deserve to lose that number one seed. Because my thing is, now you guys don't deserve to have the number one seed starting Taysom Tebow. He's a bum. He's a bum. The only two games he look good versus was the Falcons. And the Falcons are some shit. So it's like at the end of the day, y'all, this guy Taysom Tebow is a bum. I'm not sure why Sean Payton started him over Jameis Winston. I just don't get it. Packers got that number one seed since they beat the Packers. Since the Packers beat the Lions. So it's like at the end of the day, man. the Saints can forget about that number one seed. That's how to tell my fellow Seahawks fans. Just how us Seahawks fans had to feel last week versus the Giants. Losing to Colt McCoy. I just had to tell my Seahawks fans to forget about that number one seed, you know, last week. I'm going to tell y'all Saints fans, forget about the number one seed. Y'all not getting it because the Packers are most likely not losing their game. The only hope y'all can have is Derrick Henry goes off for 200 yards again. That's the only hope y'all can have. But, I mean, how likely is that? I mean, I wouldn't bet my money on the Titans over the Packers in Lambeau. So, at the end of the day, listen, Taysom Tebow some shit. And the bad news is I'm hearing that Drew Brees might not even be back to like the playoffs. So at the end of the day, y'all gotta line up Taysom Tebow versus Patrick Mahomes next week. Y'all can just forget about it. At the end of the day, man, this team is not good under Taysom Tebow. They just not. This guy Alvin Kamara has been a corpse ever since. Taysom Tebow's a bum. I'm not speaking about Taysom Tebow. Sean Payton, get a brain and start Jameis. As simple as that. But like I said, man, shout out to Jalen Hurts. Shout out to the Eagles. They found a way to get it done. That Fletcher Cox had one hell of a game. At the end of the day, shout out to Jalen Hurts. It's Hurt season Philly, baby. But that's all you gotta say, man. That's all. Subscribe to Chillin' Fino. I'm the phenomenal one. And I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', niggas. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', niggas. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.